Scanning for audio.
Hello and welcome to another Tin Dog podcast. This time I'll be talking about Torchwood Monthly Range number 78, Oracle. This is the last of what we're going to be calling the Ood Trilogy. It's been really nice hanging around with the Ood once again. You know what? I've said this before and I will be saying it again. Audio Doctor Who and its spin-offs, I enjoy them just so much more than the TV versions. And that's probably not an exciting thing to say or even admit, but it's kind of true. And this has just been nice. I mean, let's face it, we've got the same guy doing the Ood voice, and we've got someone who was in the Satan Pit, but you haven't got any of the recurring Torchwoody type people that you've kind of come to know and love and expect and that kind of thing. So that's kind of fine. Let's have a look at the synopsis. This title was released in December 2023. Oh, yes, it is still 2023, and will be exclusively available on the Big Finish website until the 29th of February. 29th of February, yes, next year's a leap year. And you know what that means? It means the summer will be ruined by the Olympics. And on general sale after this date. In the 43rd century, at the height of the Earth Empire, a ship from 1,000 years in the future has crashed on a lava world, and it's calling for help. How dangerous is the knowledge it offers? The Torchwood Archives sends Danny Bartok, because only an ethicist can save humanity from the future. It's so nice to have a time travel story where you're dealing with people. You're not dealing with the exciting world of Time Lords and the like. Here you've definitely got what happens if you've got knowledge of the future. Now, cleverly, this story, although it's got an Ood in it, the Ood is a projection used by the spaceship itself in order to make the humans visiting feel better. So it's not, strictly speaking, an Ood. Very important. Of course, the ship's going to be slightly more intelligent than the people visiting, but humans really don't change that much in 1,000 years, do they? Yeah, it's really nice. It's not exactly a locked room mystery, but you kind of know what's going on and you're just there, like so many other Torchwoods, for the ride and to see how badly things are going to go. And trust me, things are going to go very badly. I enjoyed this one. I did. I think I enjoyed the others a tiny bit more, but they're very different. They're all looking at different aspects of oodiness. And like I said, the Ood in this story isn't truly speaking an actual Ood. But you forget that. It's a projection. Now, I always thought it was Faraday projection, but apparently it's a Faradine projection. I'm going to have to look that one up. Look, I really genuinely thought this was a cracking story. I love audio Torchwood. I love it more than I ever loved Torchwood on TV. And I like the way that all of the stories, although they exist in the Torchwoodverse, that's not a thing, is it? Are dark, mysterious, and the level of foreboding, well, hey, it's Christmas, everyone loves a ghost story, and a hologram, albeit a solid hologram, of an Ood, that's going to put the willies up most people. So, not the longest reviews, suffice to say that it's awfully good, and the acting is, of course, excellent, and it's very, very mysterious. But I don't want to give anything else away. I don't want to say things like, well, I just don't want to do that kind of thing. Because that's not what I'm about. I'm not one of these podcasters or even a YouTuber who goes around violently ranting about stuff. I know I'd get more clicks and I'd get more listens if I said things like, Torchwood is broken, Torchwood is damned. Well, it's not. Torchwood's just kind of great. And this is just another example of how great Torchwood is. Yes, I was expecting at least one of the Torchwood Ood stories to take place on Earth. But you know what? That's fine. It really is. Next month, I have no idea what Torchwood is bringing us. Perhaps I'll listen to one of those scary Victorian-y type ones. They're awfully good. Right. Farewell. Until next time, be seeing you.
My name is Danny Bartok of the Torchwood Archive. Let's talk. Unless you want to kill me.
From Big Finish Productions, Torchwood Oracle.
Sergeant Collins, your people have found the ship. We don't know what we'll find. It could be, as it claimed, a wreck from the far future calling for our help.
Or a trap.
We're standing in a ship from the future. Imagine what we could learn from it.
Torchwood has experience of situations like this. I'm worried about what we might find. What happened to the ship? Where are the crew?
Something else is on this planet and it wants the ship. It's got in. Not into the ship, not yet. But in our heads. It's coming across the lava. It's getting closer.
Mr. Bartok? Oh. I apologize for disturbing you.
Has something got in?
It is just the ship.
Big Finish. For the love of stories.
That was the Tin Dog Podcast. Everything discussed is the intellectual property of others. No infringement is intended. For early access to reviews, follow the show on YouTube or Twitter at Tin Dog Podcast. To contact the show, email tin-dog@hotmail.co.uk. The Tin Dog Podcast is a founder member of the Doctor Who Podcast Alliance.